the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And I bless the body of Stephen Moser for the holy water of which St. Paul writes, all of us were baptized into Christ Jesus, were baptized into his death. By baptism into his death, we were buried together with him, so that just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might live a new life. For if we have been united with him by likeness to his death, so shall we be united with him by likeness to his resurrection. And on the day of his baptism, Steve put on Christ, and on the day of Christ's coming, may he be clothed with glory.
Passing away was thought affliction, and they're going forth from us utter destruction. But they are
eyes of men indeed may be punished, yet is their hope full of immortality. Chastise them a little, they shall be greatly blessed, because God tried them and found out their gain himself. As gold in the furnace, he proved them, and as sacrificial offerings, he took them to himself. In the time of their visitation, they shall shine, and shall dart about as sparks through stubble. They shall judge nations and rule over peoples, and the Lord shall be their king forever. Those who trust in him shall understand truth, and the faithful shall abide with him in love, because grace and mercy are with his holy ones, and his care is with the elect. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
And that's a comforting thought. God has prepared a place for each of us. And my final thought of the comfort is that God has prepared a way for us to get there. Every one of us wants to go to heaven, but sometimes we don't know the way. And Thomas says, how can we know the way? And Jesus says, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to me except through the Father. We have to have that relationship. And the reality of Steve's death reminds us of just how fragile our own lives are and helps us to call to mind the things that are truly important. A faith which comes and leads us to God. A hope and trust of God's love and mercy which binds us together. And a friendship in God that binds us with each other. We are all travelers on the road called life. There are many detours, side streets, obstacles, roadblocks. But we don't need to be confused. We don't need to be lost. All we need to do is follow Jesus, and he will show us the way. He will lead us, and he will guide us. And I believe that our lives can be best summarized by the most meaningful relationship that God graces us with in this life. And these relationships are the heart of Steve's legacy. Each of us has a story. Everyone has a history built on the experiences of our family, growing up, our neighbors, our life. And every story is sacred. It deserves respect and reverence. And when a loved one dies, we go over their story, like we've been doing at the funeral home, where different people would come in. Last night, when we had a chance to sit down and eat dinner, Steve's family and his friends and his community all know very well his story. And his death reminds us that the purpose of life is to know, love, and serve God. We know that Jesus is the resurrection and the life, and we know that on the last day we will rise again, because whoever believes in Jesus will not die. They will live. Give thanks to God for everything Steve means to you. His memories, his passions, his relationship, and his legacy. Steve's first and foremost passion was the love of his life, my sister Kathleen. They were married for 48 years and traveled the world together. And they loved each other from day one to the end and beyond. His children, Steve, his wife, Linda, Liesl, and her husband, Art. And that love extended to his grandchildren. Unfortunately, Jocelyn couldn't be with us because she was taking care of the great-grandbabies, Anthony and Stefan. His grandchildren, his sister, Mitzi, who still lives in Austria with her family, and all of his friends. Now, we all know Steve's legacy had two things. First, it was his Mercedes-Benz, his cars, and his park collection. And then it was his extensive football kicking career. And I think Steve, probably because of his German heritage, valued the Mercedes-Benz car, especially the vintage ones like his white 190 SL. And through his passion for his Mercedes, he not only put back together many cars for himself, but he was also a trusted source of many rare and hard to get parts for other Mercedes bucks. And then growing up in Europe during the war, Steve, at age 11, was held a prisoner of war for 4 years. He completed his education in Europe and played professional soccer. When he came to United States in 1956, he still played soccer. But at the age of 38, he switched to football. And from that point on, Steve has become an icon in the semi-pro football and an inspiration to many of his fellow players. And
1992, at an age when most people would consider themselves lucky to walk around a block without any aches and pains, Steve was inducted into the Semi-Pro American Football Hall of Fame. He was believed to be the oldest kicker in the world, played in Hawaii, Europe, and the United Kingdom. And for the past 21 years, he played in Las Vegas at the Casino Bowl. A career that spanned almost 50 years. And he loved the crowd. He loved entertaining them with his 10 field goals in 10 seconds. Quite a feat at 81 years old. And when he asked, he said it with a smile, "This is probably the last one I'm going to play." But I know he said it many, many times before that. And I'm sure he's already on the team. I think Steve had more championship rings than he had fingers and toes. And he used to tell me, he says, "Your sister won't let me wear them all at once." And I wanted to say, "Steve, probably because if you ever fell in the lake, you'd sink with all that weight on your hands." But among the many things he did was to share his gift of kicking as a mentor and a coach to many high school and college students from around the valley. Steve was reassuring in his ability to care, his sheer support, and his sense of friendship made all the difference in the lives of many young men and women over the years, some who have gone on to become professionals. One last night I found was to go on to become a judge. And there's one very special young man by the name of Juan. They became lifelong friends. Steve's greatest gift was the ability to make friends with anyone he ever met. And after a few minutes of talking, either cars or football or whatever that person was talking about, he swore that they knew each other all their lives. And Steve loved the beauty of nature in his backyard. It was his sanctuary. He took care of all the animals, especially the squirrels and the deer. I don't think one of them ever went hungry. But this was Steve's gift. This was the way Steve lived his Christianity in the real world. This is the way he gave Christian witness of the message of Jesus. You know, there are so many great stories. We could talk here forever. But the most important stories are the ones that he passed on to each of you. Keep them always tucked safely in your heart. It's said that the greatness of man is not known by how much wealth or material or fame he's acquired in his life, but in his integrity, faithfulness, and his ability to give of himself completely and affect those around him positively. Stefan Moser was that man. I came across a poem by author unknown. It's called "Feel No Guilt in Laughter." Feel no guilt in laughter. He knows how much you care. Feel no sorrow in a smile that he is not here to share. You cannot grieve forever. He would not want you to. He hoped that you can carry on the way you always do. So talk about the good times and the way you showed you care, the days you spent together, all the happiness you shared. Let memories surround you, a word someone may say, will suddenly recapture a time, an hour, a day, that will bring him back as clearly as though he were still here, and fills you with the feeling that he is always near. For if you keep these moments, you will never be apart, and he will live forever, locked safely within your heart. Rest in peace, Stefan Moser.
Kindly rise now and we'll offer our petition.
In baptism, Steve received the light of Christ. Shatter the darkness now and lead them over the waters of death. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Our brother Steve was nourished at the table of the Savior. Welcome him into the halls of the heavenly banquet. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Many friends and members of our families have gone before us and await the kingdom. Grant them an everlasting home with your Son. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Many people die by violence, war, or famine each day. Show your mercy to those who suffer so unjustly these sins against your love, and gather them to the eternal kingdom of peace. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Those who trusted in the Lord now sleep in the Lord. Give refreshment, rest, and peace to all whose faith is known to you alone. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
The family and friends of Steve seek comfort and consolation. Heal their pain and dispel the darkness and doubt that comes from grief. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For all of us assembled here to worship in faith, that we may be gathered together again in God's kingdom. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Almighty God, we present to you the life and times of Stephen Moser. May you continue to bless us with his memories, and may you continue to give us the fortitude to live out our lives through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Kindly be seated now. sacrifice of mine may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice
at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his children.
Mercifully receive, O Lord, the offering we trustingly present for the soul of your servant, Stephen Moser, that through this sacrifice, which you ordained as the one true remedy for all, you may grant him everlasting salvation through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and
just. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for he is the salvation of the world, the life of the human race, the resurrection of the dead. Through him, the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim. Servant Steve, whom you have called from this world to yourself, Grant that he who was united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. And have mercy on us all, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Thank you.
Renewed by the nourishment of this sacred gift, we pray, O Lord, that our brother Steve, freed from the bonds of death, may rejoice to have a share in the resurrection of your Son, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Family asked me to invite all of you downstairs at the church hall for a luncheon. Inter Steve later on. So we'll finish up with some prayers. And and then you can go downstairs. With regard to people that are handicapped, you know, we have an entrance that you can go outside, you know, down the road. It's a little bit of a walk, but we do have steps in the back there. It'll take you right down, and you can go down in the hall. Then when you get on the platform, there's a lift. So the lift never made it all the way up in the church. It is what it is, huh? The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Almighty God bless us, Father, Son, Holy Spirit. And now we'll offer our final commendations for speaking. Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our brother. May our farewell express our affection for him. May it ease our sadness, strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet him again, when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. Now we take our brother to his place of rest.